Jolín. Meta. ¿Y qué tora?
Pero bueno, no es la
It is a performance space.
Thank you. So, first things first, I have to explain one, two, three things. For example, this door came from closed door. You cannot exit from there,
neither from this door.
You can only use the back door, but you can re-enter at the exhibition if you want to by making it wrong. Okay. Second thing, we are being filmed, and this film is streamed online, and will be projected here tomorrow and uploaded on YouTube and on archive. Another thing that goes together with this is that we ask from you to stay for the whole hour. It really helps us to build up the communication between us, and it really helps if you don't come and go while we are having this concert. So we would like you to commit to stay for the whole time, or not to commit and leave now. But if you feel uncomfortable in the meanwhile and you really need to go, you can still do it. But we need you to give us some sort of feedback, so we understand why exactly you left and how you think that maybe this could go better, stuff like that. Another thing is the echo. Because of the echo of the room, we need to speak one by one. And the curtains, we don't pull them, we don't destroy them, even if we don't like them. You're not allowed to destroy the curtains.
Okay.
Thank you very much. So, would you like to speak about this yesterday?
Maybe we should give you half a minute to decide if you go for a stay. Mm-hmm. And then we can.
On the two walls, as you can see, there are two works of art. Both the curtains and this painting are works of art. But I suggest that we look at this painting for now, at this work. So this is a painting, and it's in Documenta Halle, so apparently it's a painting that is exhibited in Documenta now. So what do you think about it?
Well,
other, and it's, for me, it's, well, it's dominant. And it's more about words than what is the intellect or drawing.
The beginning and the end is no real. Not, it doesn't fit together, I think. And only some little parts of this can be something to say to me.
Wings.
But
what parts? Whispers?
Maybe this part. See a connection between all.
Yeah, this makes sense because it was made from different people.
Okay.
The bird looks in the wrong direction. The bird looks in the wrong direction. All the pictures have a direction. The bird looks in this direction.
The bird.
Would you can I define the bird?
It takes a long time, but now I see the bird.
Yes.
You mean this one?
Oh, yes.
Understand better what they have to do inside here, and we asked them to do it collectively. It was very problematic because someone was painting and then someone else wouldn't like to paint or didn't know how to paint. And came up this, and we thought that we could address the question of what work is inside here. What are we doing here? Which I don't know, honestly. What I produce here, I really don't understand. What's the plus value that I sell? I don't know. They took me from Greece, they took me to do this performance. We have this impossible score every day, and we try to interpret it. And the idea, but the good thing about this work is that you can talk about the conditions of the work itself. So we can have this conversation. Yes, this is constantly the same score. Have you read the score?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. How many days is this?
This picture? An hour?
The picture or the...
No, how many days did they work on this?
From yesterday. This
yesterday. Actually, this was from the day before yesterday. We don't know how long we will keep it.
The question that comes to my mind is to ask you if there are other people inside here that they question the same thing, that they don't know what exactly they produce and how they get getting paid for what they produce, how exactly this happens. So for them it's also a kind of mystery how this works exactly. So we would like to make two categories of people who are Fordists in regards to work and post-Fordists. I mean people who work with repetition, mechanical work, they produce their art, something, an object, something like that, and people who are more getting paid for their creativity and something like that. So does this...
So you want us to make two groups?
Yes.
That was an idea, but maybe we could do something else.
I can try.
So the two categories are between the people that work with repetition and using mostly their body and The other category was for people that work with their intellect, their creativity, their mind mostly, maybe.
I work with my mind, but doing always the same thing.
Yes, of course.
Creative with your body is being repetitive somehow. Okay.
Would you like to explain maybe?
You could be creative, you're saying.
Creativity has many forms. Not really.
Yes, it's more like between
white collar workers.
No, but it's between maybe someone who would work in a factory doing this kind of work and someone who would be an artist or an academic. That was.
Okay, we can discuss about it. What do you do?
Who is working in a factory nowadays? I mean, not really.
My real job is a repetitive job, so this came after.
Yes, for example, he's working in a parking, so it's like parking, unparking.
Parking cars.
Yeah, I'm also working as a barwoman in Athens, so it's like putting things, you know. Mm-hmm. It's kind of repetitive work. I guess we should go to this group. What do you do?
It's very difficult. I work with my mind, but I think that I also have to repeat a lot, or retrace and ask the others and assemble, and then.
But what's your occupation? What's your job?
I am a civil servant in the European Commission in Brussels. Who wants to do that? It can be very repetitive. It's about lawmaking.
Mm.
So very abstract on one hand, and the other hand you have to be to understand what's going on. So it's tricky.
What do you think? In which categories should go?
Some spectrum, right? I mean, it's not, you don't have just two sides, you have a spectrum. So you have people that, like, every day move like this, or adjust claims or whatever with the head, like do the same thing mechanically with the hands over the head. And then on the other hand, you have people who, like, every moment something new happens. And then you have a spectrum in between, because you don't have this black and white in reality.
Okay, so do you suggest that we do that as a line? Scale from 0 to 100, let's say.
Yeah, but another problem is that you have two different scales. You have them working with the hand and working with the mind, and being creative or repetitive. It's two different things.
Well,
it's your problem. It's my problem too.
If we accept the manual part as part of the photos versus post photos, if photos versus post photos is just the means of production in terms of the, is it repetitive? But what Ford did, he just put, like, he'd separate the task to such little elements so that everybody was really perfect at this little thing.
Mm.
Then it doesn't matter if it's manual or non-manual. You asked for Ford as well as post Ford, and then you introduced the manual afterwards, right?
Did I?
You said repetitive, and then you said with your hands.
Yes.
So
yes.
That's two different things. That's two different categories.
Mm. Okay, so.
So, for example.
I thought you said it also, but.
So for example, a performer works with the body.
Mm. Do they?
So. Or an actor, let's take an actor. They work with the body. On stage. On stage,
you're
of
an
course,
actor.
Also with the mind. But, it's, but like, if they break a leg, that's a big problem.
It
so
is.
They, and then that really disturbs their work. While if you're working on a desk, like if you have a broken leg, it doesn't really. So that's a very physical work, but at the same time, it's not completely repetitive.
It's
kind of repetitive because you have to do the same, like you try to reenact the same play for like 20 times. So it's not completely creative, but at some point it's. But it's really two different categories, the body versus mind and the repetitive versus non-repetitive.
And perhaps we can do two groups, how everybody every person feels in the moment. Yes,
I
can say, okay, in this moment I would I prefer to look at this part of my job. Yes, and then I can. Perhaps it's interesting.
So who is at the one end, whatever end? Who is says
that just creative and
the very creative
and repetitive, or non creative and not creative?
Okay.
So creative.
Just that side's creative, that side's not creative.
And not creative because other people say what you have to do, and you do it, and this. Part you have your own ideas, you do it, and this part you do what other people say?
I don't know. So every evening, because instead of getting
I interrupt a little bit because the girls want to leave and they want to leave some feedback before they go.
Sorry to interrupt your discussion, but we thought it was going to be a more passive performance and we feel tired, so we'd rather be somewhere else to rest. That's why I feel like we need to leave. Sorry.
Thank you.
Okay.
I was just saying, as opposed to trying to get really nitpicky and as people generally do, go into the fine details of what is and what isn't and how is and who isn't, and you end up not doing anything. Kind of just wondering, if you think your job is creative, you do that, and if you think your job isn't creative, you go to that group. Because generally, I could say that what I do, because I'm an architecture assistant working my way towards permanent architect, what I do now isn't that creative, so I could be in that group, but it depends how I feel. So I'm going to put myself in that group. Because
in the creative group?
Yeah.
Try to get into a more artistic career. And so I'm
interested.
Not so. I think also you're the only point of reference because you're the only person that everybody knows what you do. So it makes sense that you're in the middle and then we can kind of relate to that. That's what I do. Just so like, okay, this is, like,
I'm this person, so where do you see yourself from me?
Do you think it would help if we would all share what we do?
Yeah.
Okay.
Interesting.
So you said? So I'm studying to become an architect. So in the UK, I don't know if it's the same everywhere else, but you're an architecture assistant until you qualify. So it takes like 7 years. So I'm in my fourth year. Going into my fifth year. And I'd say it's not that creative now because when you're at the bottom of the pile, you're doing other people's work. So you're making everyone else's work look nice. So you're creative in making it look nice, but you're not designing and doing really interesting stuff.
Yet.
Yet, exactly.
I'm in between jobs. I was working as a project manager for large IT projects until last week, and in October I started working at a university as a head of administration.
I make a theater for children. I'm actor.
What do you do?
For children, theater for children.
Yes.
I give people energy treatments so they feel better, and I also paint.
I'm a performer here,
I'm studying fine arts and at the same time I work here.
I'm working at the University of Kassel. I'm something like a professor.
In what field?
Something like a professor for teacher training.
Okay.
And why do you think it's not creative?
I do my lessons, I do my lectures, and it's very often the same thing. Sometimes
yes,
I'm creative, yes.
For example, you prepare your lectures,
yes.
You pick your subjects, you find the structure of the lecture, of the lesson, of the course, blah, blah.
Do you think that's creative?
Yes.
Yes, really?
Okay.
Okay.
Should we continue?
I'm working as a waitress and studying geography.
So what are you studying, sorry?
Geography.
Geography.
I'm also working as a waitress and I'm studying literature. I think I'm not allowed to be here, but I feel here. I work as a head of an art department in a secondary school, and I'm a visual artist myself. But today I feel like I'm not creative.
Yes, me too. I feel it's creative to be in this part. I normally play the harpsichord. I am also sculpture, and I help people with.
So could we try to think what we are doing here, because this was our honest question about the day. The only thing that comes out as an outcome of this work is this video. Nothing else. And the video is uploaded online and anti-copyright for everyone. They can use it, they can do whatever they want. So I really don't understand what I'm producing.
Well, this is debatable. Like, you could say that the only, material product of this performance is the video. But also there is the experience that we get, and many other things, I guess, you might see. So it would be interesting if we could define what is the product of this performance.
And what about the people watching?
Yes, big problem.
Right now, because I probably have a different experience than those that watch later.
Let's hope they answer.
Why do they have a different experience?
Because they know it's now.
Ah, okay.
And they can't, like, go, like, somebody who watches later probably talks to one of us and then research. So some, might be some of us who goes back and tries to rewatch that, or people that watch this tomorrow here. They walk into this room, they don't even intend to watch it, and they walk in and they see it,
mm-hmm.
because it's there.
Mm-hmm.
But people who are online now probably chose. They didn't stumble upon it, they chose to watch it tonight for some reason, so they might be disappointed. So it's different from, or not, I mean, but it's a different experience if you choose to go somewhere and if it's in the moment. It's a bit like theater and video, and like if you're in the theater at the same moment, or if you're watching it at the same moment, it's different than watching
yes.
it. I don't see DVD in there.
We all have a reason why we're here, right? Or we think we have a reason why we're here.
The girls, I think that they don't have
reason.
Well, we just saw the line, and we were standing in the line before, and we talked to a woman, and she said, like in the DDR, so you're standing in a line, you don't know what are you waiting for. And we said, like, well, let's try it again.
Making sounds.
Ah, because it's very interesting acoustic, yes, it's a very high room. Yeah, it sounds good, it's true.
Yes, it's true.
Ooh.
fit in order to practically understand how we are generally instrumentalized. Prepare the audience with concepts, questions, and movements as a way to explore the dissonance that exists between the individual narcissism that capitalism promotes and our social capacity, between how we conceive ourselves as free individuals with agency and the way that we are socially determined by capitalist relations, technology, and ideology. Reflect on the I-we relation while defining social dissonance. Help the collective subject to emerge.
But we don't have an audience to play with.
Yeah, we are.
But they don't react right now. They will react tomorrow. So we then don't have a reaction.
Whose score is this? Is this your score? Is this our score? Are we the audience and it's your score? Is it our score?
That's Martin's score.
So, it's not yours. You can take it when you enter. So
we are the interpreters. This is not our score. This is Martin's work. This is how the artist is scoring.
For example, it says, help the audience to da da da. And the question is that something that every one of us should do? Like, should every one of us ask questions, create movement, etc.? Or is it something that you as performers do? We are the audience, and it's still a collective work, and it's still the collective subject that emerges, but the score then speaks to you to say, and we just know the score, but we don't, it's not our obligation to make it happen. And then also then the question is, who's the audience that we are engaging as soon as we, if it's part of what we do?
So
then it becomes difficult to actually execute it.
Yes, you're asking that, but at the first minutes we spoke about this work of art as a work of art, and actually it was the audience who did it. So are they also working here or not? I mean,
it's not saying that we're not working. It's just the question is whether these the instructions in the score are for everybody in this room, in terms of, like, for example, prepare the audience with concepts, questions, and movements. Like, is that on every one of us, or are we the audience, and it's your job to prepare us with concepts, questions, and movements in order so that we emerge as subject. And because there will be nobody left if it's on us, because it's difficult to engage, like to get feedback via internet from the people that we would engage there. By logical deduction, I would say, okay, we get to know the score, but we just play along. Well, it's your privilege to provide the questions, the movements, and the concepts.
I think that you're also doing it. Even if you don't really understand that you're doing it or saying it, you are, with your questions, movements, and the concepts that you are, you know, talking about here, I think you are...
Interpreter.
Interpreting this part. But this is my opinion. Maybe you disagree.
The question is, what defines the difference between audience and performer? And you said that it's a privilege somehow to be a performer. So who defines the privilege? Is it the fact, for example, that we work here and that we're being paid? Because we have access to exactly the same score in order to act, in a way. So we both have access to the score. But somehow, three of us are more privileged than the rest. So who gives us this privilege?
Who gives you the privilege to be?
Whoever let you in before the door.
Yeah, that's awesome. We were in before the door opened. But they are really possible.
But we have the same score, that's the thing.
I feel like the same thing has
has happened again. So like when you asked us to get into groups, the discussion becomes about how you define the group. What is the group really? Who is the group? Is this kind of the group or maybe not the group? And now it's like, okay, instrumentalize the audience. And it's like, but who is the audience? Do we get to instrumentalize the audience? Am I not the audience? I feel like people, and they are gone. And just generally, I feel like people do that anyways, just in life. You get to the nitty gritty, not even nitty gritty, you just kind of get to the, you nitpick at things that aren't really important, so you don't actually have to do anything, or you don't actually have to be here or there. Everyone's just in the middle, because we don't just say, okay, this is what it is, this is what I'm going to do. It's never good or bad, everything is just kind of a low
hum. So what's the important part?
What's the important part?
Yeah, because we're not doing the important part.
I mean, we could just do the action, we could just read it and say, okay, I'm going to do this, and then you can explain why you chose to do that, as opposed to trying to explain the actions. You could do the action and then explain why you've chosen to interpret in that way, as opposed to trying to interpret the explanation of the instruction, you know?
What's the action? The action is me.
I think the fact that we are filmed and there is an audience somewhere out there makes us act in a certain way or feel different.
Include the gaze in your action, maybe.
It's the people who look at you and you don't know that who they are. That's the first thing. It's like the gaze, gazing, and satisfying some curiosity. Inner curiosity of each human being, just what is doing, what are they saying, and why, and what is it? And
maybe
capitalism is a word when you hear it.
So you are afraid of the audience, but
everything
can be seen.
I'm not afraid of the audience, I just want to try to understand.
Maybe that's, but maybe you're just more aware of it now that there's a camera here.
Yeah,
but I feel like
camera,
generally, if it's, so I'm just looking at the word of, to practically understand how we are generally instrumentalized. And maybe being so aware that there's a camera looking at me right now, we're kind of conscious of, okay, how do we do this and how do we do that? And we're openly questioning it. But generally in your day-to-day life, you probably do that anyways. And there is a general consensus of how things go and how people do things. And that is how you are instrumentalized.
Exactly.
But it's just, you're not so aware of it on a daily basis. But now you're like, okay, so how do we do the thing? Because this is what it says, but there's a camera here, so are we doing the thing right, and what does the thing mean? Yeah. Basically, I think we all just overthink life too much. Don't do enough life. Spend too much life thinking about how to do life. I'm going to stop talking now.
Yeah, so we
start
the singing again.
Yeah, because it sounds so nice here.
I don't think anybody enjoyed it.
I know, uncomfortable for many people, but it's also interesting to watch how uncomfortable people are, because I don't know.
So maybe you could try it again by walking around, so that we are not focused on each other, but just listening to the sound.
Okay, and maybe we can try also to enjoy it.
Yes,
yeah.
Exactly. Yeah.
But why is this better?
I wonder why
that singing feels better than talking about this. Because, for example, singing and dancing, we can do in practically any environment, but we are here now and we can discuss about things and we can understand something.
I don't think it's that singing or dancing is better. I think it's just the fact that doing that would be an action, and then you can talk about it afterwards and say, how does that make you feel? As opposed to being about to do it and then talking about why that's better than not doing something else.
It's also a cop-out, because he asked us, what are we doing here? And we, instead of answering this question, we just do something else.
But
and we just chill, instead of reflecting on what happened in the first 30 minutes in terms of what are we doing here, what is this? Is this art? Is this performance? What is this? We just now decided that we do something else and then maybe talk about it afterwards.
I don't think it's doing something
so
else.
We're not asking you questions.
For me, it's the acting out of the deadlock. We found, also yesterday it happened, and people start painting, whatever.
Like, yeah, exactly.
Before they come to a consensus, they start painting. So we didn't manage clearly for me to create a collective subject.
Today there's no painting.
There are.
We have still the colors.
Yeah.
Do you want to paint?
I think we should just do something.
I would like to paint.
Yeah.
Or we can maybe deal with the awkwardness.
I just said, you can just do anything to make everyone feel like awkward, anything.
What is this here? Do you want to face? I would like to make voices together, but...
Shall we make two teams? People who want to act and people who want to think?
We could do that.
Yeah, we could
do anything.
But what I don't get is that we start with having a discussion, what are we doing? And then you refer to yesterday that it was hard to find a subject.
Mm-hmm.
For me, that's two different things. What are we doing now? Are we having a discussion about what are we doing here, or are we looking for a subject to talk about? Because that's, I think, two different things, or not?
Mm-hmm.
So for me, this difference is as weird or whatever. As starting to sing or to paint together.
Mm. Definitely.
Sorry, I just...
to the discussion.
Sorry.
We are also allowed not to do anything.
Yeah.
So we can just be silent for 5 minutes.
And what happens when every person do what he and she likes?
What happens?
This. You're singing and other people painting. It's really interesting.
Some people are talking together.
The noise is
perhaps to get confusion first, or perhaps it goes together.
But there are individual solutions, like everyone enjoys himself or herself individually.
Yes, and perhaps you meet other people and you say, oh, yeah, that's very interesting. I will do the same. Could be.
Do you all agree in that? In that idea?
We can, at least we can try it.
Like the same before we try reading?
You will.
Why not?
Thanks. You will dance, and I will paint. I don't know what to say. No? Yes?
Yeah.
Okay.
So you want to sing?
I can't. I can sing, but I want to act.
I like it.
Thank you.
said, let's now do what we really want to do. And yeah. it is as if before that we weren't doing what we wanted, and then we had defined from now on, we have this 3 minutes to do what we really want to do.
Okay.
No, just an observation and my personal view of how things are evolving. And yeah, I forgot the rest.
Yes, and also you said, let's do something, let's start with an action and then have the time to reflect on it. Like talking is not an action. And actually this, in terms of the musical part of the piece, this is exactly what I think what this piece wants to point out, that also talk, like we're talking, and this is some kind of social music, I don't know. So yeah, and I think this also is an action, and a very active one. Yeah, I can't say that, but yeah, when we speak all together and we try to figure out what we're doing. I mean, this is usually some of my most fruitful times in the performance, in the concert. But yes, it was interesting that today that we tried to figure out a little bit more about our role and your role and the fact that we are working, but you're also producing something here, but you are not paid, but we are paid. And this is all so complex, like. And we ended up doing something very individual, yeah. Like, I think it was a little bit, maybe too complex to continue talking about it. So we just somehow, I feel that we tried to break this situation by doing whatever anyone wanted to.
But maybe now it's more easy to understand, actually. You know what I mean? That you sort of need an action to have an idea what you are doing. I don't know. You saw, I think, how many of these performances already, so you know what a group, what happens, and I think this is what you need to understand to understand each other, sort of, because language is quite difficult, I think, to start with nothing and then just talking, and it's really vague, you know, and then if you have something in common, then you start looking for this, what's in common, and then you can have a discussion about it. I don't know if that's...
The thing was never that the conversation isn't productive or isn't an action. It was at the point where we were discussing actions or actions before anything. It wasn't like that it was going anywhere, it was just kind of hitting a wall of, okay, we could do this, but what does that mean, and we didn't do anything. But at least having a little shake it off, okay, come back,
yeah,
talk again. That was I feel like that was my main.
I still don't. I still haven't answered my initial question, and it seems more complicated than I thought. I want somehow to bring this discussion up to the fact that we are a lot of people and we are thinking together. Maybe this was somehow of any value. The conversation was the value that we produce, but I really don't know. And when people do whatever they want after a while, I remember two things, that people just want to have fun and to express themselves in these terms, like good, bad, having fun, not having fun. They just want to like themselves, which reminds me again how individualistic is this process and how I am very individualistic about having this job still, when I could have left, for example, left. But I'm still doing it, and it's so difficult to become productive, but we're still doing it. We're still trying for this impossible thing, and that's it.
Isn't it also a bit individualistic? individualistic, because we came here, us three, with a very sincere need to talk about these things, like our labor conditions and stuff, and to discuss it with you so that we ourselves can find out exactly what is happening. But this is also an individualistic thing, like we came with our need, and you came from this huge exhibition, tired and wanting to release stress maybe, or wanting to watch something. So it's like...
I was just curious.
So the purpose of this was to have this emergence of the collective. Everybody does what they want, or are we already discussing at the group? Especially if you look over there. I tell you something, because I was listening to you and watching them, and you saw, and then one part of the group, and at that point it was still a group, but then I felt that when you started the conversation, it fell apart because nobody paid attention that they are not there.
When we are sitting, I feel we are communicating to people, because I feel we have sounded like it sounds like in a very old forest, yes?
Yeah.
In a wild forest, wildness. I hear wildness, and I saw there strange figures and people, and so I have a little bit like it was a conversation between the painter and the people who are singing.
I
like it very much, because Mengisch is not so good. Something I do not understand. So for me, it would be much better to make sounds and to paint and to feel together with the group without a conversation with words. So for me, it was much better.
I guess if we want to have a conversation as a group,
we should
invite them to join us.
Oh.
I mean, if that's what you want. I don't want to interrupt your discussion. Just suggest that you invite them to join. Should we do that?
Yes.
Friends. Shall we wrap up and come together as a group and discuss?
What did you say?
I was just suggesting that we come together as a group again to have a collective experience in the end, in terms of not people wandering off in every direction, but coming together and thinking about, was this emergence of a collective subject, or whatever the term was, or how did we, where are we? Hey! Thank you. So,
I think that the individuality of people are important, and what we think and do, and not mainstream.
Mm-hmm.
And this word capitalism, and doing things repetitive, and now we should do this and that. Therefore, I think some people broke out. And
can I ask a last question? How many of you pay taxes? How many of you pay taxes?
I get more than I pay.
Okay. I want to see if the acting group was also the group that were paying taxes.
Yes, sir.
I want to see if the people that they had this tendency to act were more identified with the people that they act on their daily lives also, and they are part of this
capitalist
production, because you...
No,
yeah, if you are paid taxes, you invest something to take back. You invest your money.
It's not, but it's not, right? You ask at Google, but there is not a...
because only the five of us don't pay taxes.
Yeah.
But I think just one question. You said because some of them broke out. That's what you said.
Well, they just did the thing. I mean,
that's a really interesting.
For me, it's quite interesting.
Did you break out? Did you leave the group, or did you feel that this was a space where you could be part of the group and do what you want to do?
Yes, second. Yeah, it was nice.
So why do you say that you broke out?
Well, it's just I just acted.
Okay.
I didn't want to stand there any longer and talk about whatever, not really defined, not clear, not. And then there are people they talk a lot and there are people they don't talk, and then there are people who like to sing, you know, and I think it's great, there's a good thing, and I do my thing, and you talk.